This is Ramara Designs. This is Uganda Craft. They make these fascinating baskets.
Adaldiak brand is a brand of luxury fashion accessories.
This is the Simply Sandra collection. She creates her own fabric.
Here we have some of the bags that I was telling you from the kitenge.
We focus on designers who are doing everything which is handmade, and we offer market development, so we create an awareness or produce information for where markets are, who they can work with.
She's used stuff like Ankole Kahon from Uganda. She's used recycled brass. She's used recycled aluminium. She's used bags, aside from the ones that are here with the kitenge, she uses the bags are made from mud cloth, a cowhide, and Alexia from South Africa.
This is the second symposium, but the first gallery exhibition, which now we are trying to make Kenyans engage more with design in the contemporary handmade sector. This is a piece of chair, and the whole chair can be assembled and deassembled and put away. So this is set for like somebody who has a small living space and wants to manage it and be able to have a functionable house, remove some pieces, add some pieces. Yes, you have your full chair. You can sit comfortably in it. Uganda Craft is a social enterprise that employs around 300 women in Uganda who all make a basket which is different from each other. This is something that they learned traditionally over the years, passed down generation to generation that it's here. But also this points out to the unfortunate nature of the schooling system, not only in Kenya but across the region, where the arts are not given enough, nobody's addressing them adequately. So you find such techniques will soon die off, because even the people in design school, they are taught to be designers but not artisans. So such quality of work might eventually fade away if we are not careful to protect it and even offer it in our schools. This is the Design Kingdom designs. The Design Kingdoms are actually a couple, a man and his wife, who came from Ethiopia, but they've been living here for quite a while. The way the doors are placed, it's very 1960s old inspired. But they added, most of the handmade designs borrow a lot from the aesthetics of old Africa, but are now being tried to be made into a contemporary way to fit the modern day. This is a work desk or a student desk, and you can see with the design how simple it looks, and nobody will know there's a drawer beneath it. So this is some of the design that we are talking about, thinking outside of the box and doing something different. But conservation is generally important because we are advocating for people to use locally sourced materials, but with that also the need for conservation emerges, because we want these things to be available for future generations. These are designs by Leek. Leek is a floral artist. This is made of grass, soft hay grass, and it's layer upon layer upon layer of grass, dried grass, and then on top they just put a patch of glue. So this has been one of the most conversation sourcing pieces in our whole exhibition. I'll explain the method for Simply Sandra. One day she was having a cup of tea outside her house, and so she saw some grass swinging in one of the trees, and she was very impressed by it. So she started sketching, and she did a little sketch of the grass, and from that she created a pattern out of the grass that she saw swinging, and it's right now one of our best-selling fabrics, which you can see hanged here. This is the end product. So it's to also show you that design doesn't have to be complicated. It can be very simple but very ingenious. She's gone beyond that, and she started a small furniture company where she's able now to even go further in quality enhancing, or in enhancing her products, and she's now using her fabrics in her own furniture and home decor.
This is leather and suede, and you have the bone, so, and the recycled aluminium. Ankole Kahon from Uganda, a cow bone, recycled brass, recycled aluminium. You know, these are not stuff you'd expect to find guys using to make accessories and jewelry. this center, a unique piece made from cow bone and recycled brass. You can use it as a chandelier, as a centerpiece for your decorative house. Yes, and the fact that it's made from something unique, it's just so enticing, so beautiful, so great, so African.
What we have on display here is creations of a company that was started by a Dutch lady who came to Kenya, and she started teaching women on the technique of paper mache. And so that's how Afro Paper Dutch was born. These are old recycled newspapers turned into these wonderful creations. They go with the usual technique of paper mache. The paper stone comes from the effect that the paper mache creates. So as you can see, the quality or the paper stone creates a stone effect. And that's where the paper stone comes. And this is what they've come to be known for. This is a gourd, and the gourd is covered in the paper mache. So this is one of the ingenious ways that you perfect your skill and create art which is durable. Gourd in the inside and paper stone on the outside. And most people think that because this is paper, then it means it's very fragile. And why would I want to put something fragile in my house? But you'll be surprised to know that using very skilled technique, they're able to create very durable products. So this is by some ladies called Spirit Ethnic. Most of their artisans are based in Machakos. And most of their work is metalwork, and it's all done by hand. And they do different pieces, but it's all inspired by the African aesthetic. Their main form of expression is metal, but that does not limit them into using other materials. So you can see they have a lot of wood also. Also been inspired by African mask, and this is also a lamp created out of the African mask. This is the most sold piece. It's called Mama Elephant. And so they usually have a set of these. There's the mother, there's the father, there's the little babies. This is something you can put in the garden. Can be rained on. You don't have to stick to the same old, do something different, and it might just surprise you, like the ladies were so surprised to find that this would be their best seller. Yes. So these designs are by a lady known as Maliza. Maliza lives in Kenya, but she's of Congolese descent. She has Congolese descendants in her. As you can see in her art perspective, she's very big on collages. These are collages, and this is called her Portraits of Nairobi collection. This, of course, shows the normal urban Kenyan, the Afro man, running around doing his errands. Her raw material is the simplest thing you can find, just car or sticker paper that is mostly used on car stickers. And so she's just used that and found a different way to form an expression of what she thinks. This shows the upcoming Asian influence in terms of the Japanese, the Chinese coming in and how we are mingling with them. The second collection, of course, is what we call Nairobi cowboys. All the men, young men going around in cowboy hats. So, and that's what she's trying to depict here. And the last one, of course, shows the Singh community in Kenya, and you can identify that with their turbans. She considers herself an artist first, but she's not trying to find different ways of expressing her creativity through functional items. These are her pillows. So all her products are hand-painted through various inspirations. This is a couple from Lamu, and their design work is called Ali Lamu, and it has a very human story behind it. This lady came to Kenya and met with a man from Kenya, and of course they fell in love, and over the years they've used this theme as part of their collection, and they picked the old sails, and they use them to create functionable items. And so they do bags, they do pillows, but a lot of bags, their bags are the best sellers. The way I'm talking about the aesthetic, in this pillow you can see there's a patch. the old sales, when they come in, a lot of them are in tatters, and they keep it very authentic to show people that this is a product made of reusable or recycled material. This is not something that you get today and it spoils tomorrow. So still I insist on quality. And one of the things they are also delving into is the sails, kite sails or kite surfs. And so this is the new product that they are using right now. And they're using, of course, tattered kite surfs and using them for the bags. So this is a hammock, yes, of course, that's obvious. But this is also done by a guy who's also a traveler, and he went to Rwanda. And in Rwanda, he bumped into, of course, started a small social enterprise empowering women. They found that the cost of sourcing the rope from India all the way to Rwanda was costly. In terms of tariffs, taxes, and all that kind of stuff. And so they moved their productions to Kenya. So the Bombolulu women, who are disabled women and disabled women who have founded a craft enterprise, are the ones who are now doing the work for him. So the handiwork is by all these women. All these women have disability, one or the other, but it also shows that disability is not inability. They are making the useful time of their lives. His biggest clients are hotels who create amiable spaces where their guests can go relax, but it's also proven quite the hit with people with homes, recent home buyers who want to just settle in and have a place where they can go and just have a relaxing moment after a long day at work. This is Sky Deco. Their source of material is aeroplanes. This is a table, as you can see. Oil, probably I'd have to say, but this is a table. And the table is taken from the wing of the aeroplane. Old aeroplanes that they take and refurbish into furniture. And so these are two young boys, Kenyan, who out of their spare time they started experimenting with different materials, and this is how this emerged. This table we are standing on is they are using the propeller as the base. Their designs are delicate but also very sturdy, very well polished or finished. You can see just from the amount of, or how they put it in, it's just the quality of design or time they put in. You can see how they've managed to think outside of the box. And the other thing is that when they get these aeroplanes, they're mostly very old, non-functionable aeroplanes. Somebody is able to see the aeroplane actually in its pure aesthetic as it is. You can see the simple bolts used to hold things together. There are a lot of old planes in Kenya. And the other question that most people ask is, how many planes have you used so far? And the answer to that is also, they've just used 3 planes. All these materials are readily available. Bamboo grows a lot in Western Kenya. And the product is very sturdy. People ask, say like, oh, is it, am I going to fall off? And that's why we've let people come and see. You can sit on it and actually see how sturdy it is. So Bamboo is an organization led by a Kenyan known as Polycap. And Polycap has been doing this for a couple of years. He uses bamboo as his raw material in creating home decor and furniture. The bed is also still by Kenya Bamboo. As you can see, the bed is a low-lying bed inspired by, I think, the Japanese or something. But it's also very sturdy. They've used the thickest bamboo you possibly can find. We asked a lady from Kenana Knitters to make us the beddings that will go with this bed. Kenana Knitters, as you can see, uses just, they knit their products. All their products are knitted. All their pieces are different, very unique, because each piece is done by a different woman. And each piece, when it's done by a different woman, they print her name. So everybody, you're able to know who did the design. As you can see, this was done by Gladys Jambi. The toys are sold globally. And these are just simple dolls that children can play with. And they've a lot of fascination has been around them. As you can, I told you, all the products are knitted, so even their animals are knitted. And they're very comfy. The product they use also is microfiber inside. With your baby, you are sure that they are going to be comfortable with it, cannot scratch them or something of the sort. Yes, collaboration is very essential, because you'll find that one designer is known for one type of thing or one type of material and the other designer for another thing. So it's always good to try and see how can these two things come and meet. This is by Matupo Pottery. Matupo Pottery is based in Mozambique. The founder of Craft Africa is one of the ladies who's been hosting a program where artisans from all over East Africa are meeting together and sharing or exchanging ideas in how they can advance their designs. And that's where we found Matupo Pottery from. This is just a normal horn, but through design work, it's been turned into a fancy horn. Actually had one lady come in here who was laughing and saying, you know, I own a butchery and we throw all the bone away, and when I come here I see a lot of people making money through bone. So yes, these are just locally sourced material which anyone can get. Our strength is the skill or craftsmanship that is passed on generation to generation. So hands down, we have that. Yes, and you'll find that this is something of a cultural passing down of something. But the weakness now is that it's a different world, it's a dynamic world, so things are changing. People are looking at products differently. We're not just looking at a stool as something, a three-legged stool as something to sit on.
It's when you have a passion for something and believe in something, you've got to be confident in it. You've got to showcase it. You've got to tell the world and let the world...
For the Kenyan or African designers pushing the envelopes in terms of configuring products that are now can now be able to function in the new setting. So that has been one of the major weaknesses. So you find, and that's something that you can see even with the local artisans, is that they're doing the same thing over and over. A calabash is a calabash is a calabash.